إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. ثم أما بعد، سئل الإمام علي رضي الله عنه: ما الخير؟ علي رضي الله عنه, the cousin of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the fourth Khalifa of the believers, and the husband of the daughter of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the one who accepted Islam when he was 9 years old, one of the Mubashshareen bil Jannah, great Sahabi رضي الله عنه. He was asked, what is khayr? What is goodness? قال رضي الله عنه: ليس الخير أن يكثر مالك وولدك. Khayr is not by having too much money or too many children. ولكن الخير أن يكثر علمك وعملك. Khayr is to be increased with knowledge and action. وَأَنْ يَعْظُمَ حِلْمُكَ, and to be more forbearing, more patient. وَأَنْ تُبَاهِ النَّاسَ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّكَ, and if you want to compete with people, compete with serving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنْ أَحْسَنْتَ فَأَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ, if you did good, say Alhamdulillah. People, when they go to Jannah, what do they say? Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana li hada. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who guided us to this. Wa in asa'ta fastaghfirillah. If you did bad, then say astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah removes the sins, cleans your heart from the filth and the impurity of sinning. Let's take a look at his wording. ليس الخير أن يكثر مالك وولدك. Having too much money and too many children is not a sign that you are being blessed in the sense of having good things. That money and children, both of them, tests. And the money could be a reason to deviate you. And not having too much, and many people think that when you have too much money, you're not going to involve in haram. Why would you involve in haram, brother? You have the money, you buy anything you want, and you're not going to get this and going to get that. But you never have enough as a human being. The more you have, the more you want. And that is what the Prophet ﷺ told us. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمًّا. There is a limited love and there is an inordinate love. Love that has no limits. And that's how much we love money. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam confirmed it by saying, if the son of Adam has a valley of gold, valley. Just picture that. If you have a handful of gold, you're so rich. A valley of gold, you would wish another one. And if you have another one, you would wish a third one. And you will keep wishing until you die, meaning you never be satisfied. So it's not this. It's not having money or children. You can have children a cause of misery in life. You can have one bad child that ruins your whole life. So that is not. The focus, he said, Ali radiallahu anhu qal, إِنَّمَا الْخَيْرُ أَنْ يَكْثُرَ عِلْمُكَ وَعَمَلُكَ. Knowledge. This 10 minutes that you sit and listen is worth so much of goodness, more than someone working all day and gaining and making and earning and having fun and whatever. Because knowledge is what really makes you do for the hereafter. Knowledge is what makes you really do right for the hereafter. Not everything you do is correct or accepted. If you don't have knowledge, you don't know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants or how He wants it. You want to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but you have no idea how to do it. Or maybe you do it the way you feel like it. That's not worship. So knowledge gets you to the right worship. And if you have knowledge, to be good, you have to work. That's what I said. That's why he said, "علمك وعملك." That means you learn and you act. This action will be good because it is based on knowledge. Anything based on knowledge, then it is good. But if you don't have the knowledge, then it could be innovation, it could be wrong, any other reason that makes it invalid and not accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said, وَأَنْ يَعْظُمَ حِلْمُكَ. Your patience is going to be intensified and increased. You may have some patience, but what is khayr is to have too much of it. Constantly, you're improving. How do you improve? Knowledge is going to get you there because it tells you how bad anger is and how bad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates it and how evil it is to you and to people around you and how much sins it will make you fall into. Not to mention that shaitan loves it. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that if you say A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim, you calm down. Why? Because it is caused by the shaitan. And when you say A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim, you're seeking refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from him, so you calm down. So if you don't have that control on yourself, you're lacking knowledge and you're lacking action and you are not considered from those who have the goodness or the khayr that the person was asking about. And then he said, وَأَن تُبَاهِ النَّاسِ بِعِبَادَتِكَ لِلَّهِ أَوْ لِرَبِّكَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. If you want to compete with another person, look at the other person. What is he doing? What are you doing, brother? How much you read Quran? A juzu? I'm going to read more than one juzu. You do qiyam, brother? MashaAllah. How many rak'ah you pray on? Sometimes I pray two. I'm going to pray four. You give charity, how much you give? $10? I'm going to give 20. So whatever people doing, you compete with them. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, one fundraising, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was encouraging. Yeah, probably surprised that there was no fundraising, so you think, at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you thought this is a bid'ah? No, it's not. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was encouraging for participation and for helping. Umar ibn al-Khattab had some cash, you know, on the side, so he felt good and he wants to give and he's generous. So he said, today is the day. I'm going to beat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu because he's known that he always beats him in everything. He said, today is the day. He's not going to get me. That's it. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked everyone, what did you do or how much? Umar ibn al-Khattab said, half of what I have. It's a lot. How much do we give? So he said, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, how much? He said, everything. He told him, what did you leave for yourself and your family? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. Umar ibn al-Khattab, after that, he said, this is it. I would never compete with him again. Khalas, yani this person, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him so much. It's a joke to think. I mean, when you give everything and have the yaqeen, the trust that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide, this is way too much. That means knowledge, he has reached a level of knowledge. Remember, he is with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all the time, radiallahu anhu. So, hilm is that. You gain knowledge, you would have the hilm and control over yourself. And when you have control over yourself, shaitan is away from you. And when shaitan is away from you, you are less likely to fall into sins. Increased knowledge, action, patience or forbearing, and then competing with people with good. It's not like, oh my, he got a nice car, I'm gonna get my nice car like him, whether I can afford it or not. I'll just get payments, it's okay, because some sheikh said it's okay in the United States to get with haram and halal and all of that. Because when the human being wants to satisfy himself, which is itself, that self, the self of ours that hates obligations, likes everything she desires, when you become a servant for yourself, not for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything off the table. So you'll find every excuse to justify every action. And every ruling you will find someone to tell you it's okay, or some halal, or some weak evidence, or whatever reason. So you compete with that person, because he has a car, you have a car. You know, I know personally a situation that a sister, she has a friend sister who's a doctor. And this sister is a nurse. And you cannot compete a nurse with a doctor, cash-wise. She, the doctor, had a huge house. She bought a new house, building a new house. The nurse wants to do a house like her, even though she has a good house, big house, paid for house. This is a real thing that the husband was crying, telling. And he said, I can't afford it. And we can't afford it. We can't compete with them. They have too much money. And we have a house and it's more than enough. And no, she insisted, and they went through divorce. All she wants is to match her friend. That's not the competition we're talking about, or Ali radiallahu anhu is talking about. Competition in goodness, not in dunya. In dunya, let everybody pass you. In the hereafter, you need to pass everyone. And then he said, finally, if you do good, say Alhamdulillah. You thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he is the one who helped you and guided you. And if you do bad, say Astaghfirullah. Everyone is going to slip and fall. Astaghfirullah will bring you back on track. So take that advice of Ali radiallahu anhu. Focus on seeking knowledge. Focus on action. Focus on controlling yourself. And compete with people for the hereafter, not for this dunya. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.